from Sandy's pitch as I was our collision, and the car flipped like a pale blue top, spun beyond the reach of its sunbeam, suspended in time, like if it's relative. I've got enough to get this out. My love, when you're sitting down, no matter how small a speck we are, floating in some empty living room, you are still a world to me, and I will expect to see you at peace with the debris that I return to in your afternoons. Like the glimmer of old stars, no matter how dead they are, knowing that each and every piece was once a prelude to our eternal somethings who already knew the news. Anything could happen with the right set of lungs breathing into this room. What ifs are deafening questions. She'll learn to love again. She'll learn to love again. Something like a passing conversation adds. That seems to be all that we can have nowadays, and you seem to have lost your voice, and I seem to have lost my patience, waiting on a whisper, or a fire, or an earthquake, or a hurricane. I hid myself in the cleft of Northwest Sanctuary Cities, searching memories for rest, for new testaments to reminiscent projections of presuppositions I had about you when I left. Ode to the great iconoclast! You finally spoke through the cracks in the tarmac. You won't find me in doubling back, you said. And I am not through with you yet. And how do you teach a blind man to dance? There is salt in these wounds. Granules like pillars of pasts. Love lost and lots cast for backward glances. I fell for romancing the ashes and calling the cinders beauty. But I could still see, I couldn't believe the way that I backbeat slowly advance until I had hijacked every single step. I didn't feel my hand lose grips with your left. Suddenly I wasn't leaning back into your right, and I constantly describe the actions in the passive tense as if they all happened on accident. I knew that it was dark, I knew you were light, but I had no idea that the white was a spectrum combined. And iron doesn't cease to sharpen iron just because it sparks a tone unrecognized by your stride. Spent 3 weeks searching the skylines, hoping I'd find the words that could free my mind. I kept clenched teeth, never realizing, idealizing the past was not taken back in time. I mean, I keep on advertising a line of ascent, a decade sanctified. And I've been afraid to go forward with you, so deeply ingrained in my image, as if you could be contained. When I pray, it was only to the idea of name, and it sounded so much like mine. It sounded so much like mine. And in something like a passive altercation, as that seems to be all that we can manage nowadays, and I seem to have lost my voice, and you seem to have remained patient, waiting on a forfeit, or a dime, or a white flag, or a heartbreak. I lay awake in the bed of Northwest Sanctuary Cities, praying, God, give me rest. These Old Testaments are expensive perceptions and presuppositions that I can no longer forget. Ode to the great iconoclast! You finally noticed the lack in the flashback. You won't know me in zeros and ones and that, and I am not with you yet. And how do you teach a lame man to dance? There is pride in these wounds. I've memorized every step, fall away and promenade and sway and fell for equating a passing grade on the test with taking your hand. This speck is a beam, and I cannot lean on my own understanding as a means to the same end as suffering is. I suffocated in the tree of knowledge. I broke both of my legs at the root of good and evil. And if I'm to wonder beyond wondering where the wonder went again, I'm convinced it has to be in the mystery. Let it be in the mystery. Trying to control the future I can't define. I kept clenched teeth, Never realizing, idealizing the past is not a ticket back in time. I mean, I keep almost abiding in the present time like I believe it's true. I mean, I keep almost believing in being led into the dance with you. Thanks.